Musgrove Music.
Hello, I'm Pastor Shirley Caesar, and you are watching Must Grow Music Gospel Corner.
It's the Must Grow Music Show. It's the Must Grow Music Show. It's the hottest show around, and it's coming to your town. It's the Must Grow Music Show.
To us, big respect, never ask, because special guest of the morning, God bless you, don't know, say, second. You're watching Must Grow Music Gospel Corner. This is Papa Son from Kingston, Jamaica. Bless up. One love, check it, bless it, set it, respect it. Yeah, yeah.
The Must Grow Music Show. It's the hottest show around, and it's coming to your town.
It's the Must Grow Music Show. It's the Must Grow Music Show.
Hi, I'm Daniel Musgrove, here with Papa Son, and you're watching Must Grow Music Gospel Corner.
Bless you. Hey, you're watching Must Grow Music Gospel Corner. Stay tuned for another exciting episode.
See you there.
Stay tuned for more of Must Grow Music Gospel Corner.
It's the hottest show around, and it's coming to your town.
Hi, and welcome to another exciting episode of Must Grow Music Gospel Corner. I'm not going to hold you in suspense too long. I have a wonderful couple sitting next to me. I happen to know them personally. And I might say I'm a little bit envious, because when you hear their testimony, when you hear what they're doing right here now, you're going to know why I want to be where they are. Because these two are two halves of one whole that's entered into a union and a covenant with God, and they decided, because of their success in this covenant, they want to help train and teach others how they can be in this covenant to a lasting covenant. So let me let this gentleman right here, because I know the expression on his face when he talk about her. Now, he's going to tell you her name and all that good stuff, but I'm going to turn it over to him right now. And people, you don't believe me, watch this.
My wife's name is Pastor Sharon Johnson.
Uh-huh.
And
hold on. Y'all see that? Y'all see the smile on his face? He's like, he just met this lady. Look at that. He's actually blushing. Wow. Sorry, sir. I didn't mean to embarrass you, but go ahead, man.
And the marriage conference, this is the third annual one.
Which marriage conference? What's the name of it, sir?
In It to Win It.
Y'all hear that? In It to Win It. Well, we refer to marriage, of course.
Oh, yes.
All right. Some people, you got to clarify. Yeah. Go ahead. Introduce this lovely lady.
And the conference was one that God had given to her.
Uh-huh.
You know, marriages are the foundation of the society. And so with strong marriages come mm-hmm. a strong society. And so
mm-hmm.
once it was given it to her, it was a matter of trying to find out the right venue and presentation mm-hmm. for it. The first two marriage conferences were a bit different from this one. This one, we're mm-hmm. going to have a series of panelists, and they would be speaking on different topics. Once the topics are completed,
mm-hmm.
then we would have a question and answer period from the audience.
Okay, beautiful. Let me turn to this lovely lady. People, y'all see what I'm talking about? See the passion he was like, before he went on about the actual conference, when he said his name, he's just lit up. Now, I'm waiting for an expression from you. I want to see. Introduce him.
Hello. How are you all?
Uh-huh.
I'm Pastor Sharon Johnson.
Okay.
With my wonderful, one in a million husband, Anthony Johnson. There's only one. Married now, 36 years.
Y'all hear that? I was... I'm running out of things. 3, 6, 3. Mm. What?
Married now, 36 years.
Mm-hmm.
And we have 4 beautiful children, and our marriage was like, I feel in my spirit that we had one of the good marriages.
Mm-hmm.
We have ups and downs, but not to the point that
mm-hmm.
we get to the fist fighting and what have you.
Okay, I'm gonna lay some hard questions on you, because I see here, and I'm holding up a flyer. I'll have it on the screen so you can see it more in depth. I see here you have some very interesting speakers mm-hmm. that's gonna be appearing on your conference. I'm going to ask you a hard question,
mm-hmm.
which may be easy for you. I mean, what do you think qualifies you other than the 36 years of marriage to teach this, to teach on marriage?
Staying in it, no matter what. That's the key to a marriage. No matter what, you stay in it.
And y'all stayed
in the hard times and the good times and the low times. We mm-hmm. stayed in it. Marriage is not an arrangement. It's an agreement between you, your husband, and God at the court that holds it all together. We stay in it.
So what do you think about this new modern day thing where people are, before they get married, they sign prenups and contracts and what do you think about that?
It's not a marriage. It's an arrangement. You get 50% for you and 50% for me. That's not a marriage. A marriage is one. Mm-hmm. 100%. And when I married to him, I took on his name. My name is no longer Sharon Johnson. My name is Anthony Sharon Johnson.
Wow. Y'all hear that, folks?
It's Anthony, Mistress Anthony Johnson.
Okay.
And I became one.
Can you tell us a little bit about some of your guests? Mm-hmm. You know, people out there, if you know a good optometrist, have them give me a call because I can't see this. Can you help me out with this?
Oh, Lord, have mercy. Ooh. That's my glasses. Anyhow, I'll do my best. But I don't know if anybody heard it, but Apostle Kenneth Smith.
Apostle Kenneth, where is he from?
He's from here in Miami.
Right, Miami, Florida.
And he's a powerful, powerful man.
What? And who do we have next on there?
And then we have Dee Dee Hall.
Dee Dee Hall, Miss Dee Dee Hall, yes. Yes.
And then we also have my wonderful Bishop Isaiah Musgrove and his
I know him.
Then we have Then we have Hyde and Reginald Osberries. Yes. Then we have Minister and Prophetess Green.
Wow.
From the Bahamas. And we have Apostle Cox and Ella Cox right here in Palm Beach.
I don't want to interrupt you, but folks, you notice one thing where everyone has in common? They're married couples.
Mm-hmm.
And they're in ministry.
Yes.
So if anyone don't believe a family that prays together, stays together, I beg to differ. Hmm. I want to show you this is proof. Look at these powerful couples.
Mm-hmm.
Men and women of God coming together to teach us more about the sanctity and the unity of marriage. So tell us a little bit more. What role do you play?
Well, for the conference,
mm-hmm.
My role is basically to help organize the conference.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not speaking at the conference because we want to...
Why are you not letting him speak?
He's gonna be right.
He has the experience, 36 years. I'm just ruffling some feathers right now.
Yes. So after organizing, we'll bring in the men and women of God because people that know us in the area, they know about our marriages. We want to be able to bring in people that they don't know so that they can see that our marriage is not only not unique, but it is common in the kingdom of God.
I mean, this kind of sums it up. In it to win it.
Mm-hmm.
In it to this, when you say you're in it to win it, you think there's a prize. Just like being a Christian, there's a big prize at the end.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me, what inspired you to start this?
It's such a I'm glad you asked me that question because about 2 years ago, I was just sitting down in my den, just doing my regular Bible studies, and the Lord just dropped me going to a marriage summit. I said, marriage summit? I said, why am I doing a marriage summit?
You didn't know, where to begin,
No, not the first clue. And it all came right into me. Yes, once you have God in you, He gives you, inspires you to do what you have to do.
Plus that, at 36 years, I will say you are qualified and equipped.
Yes, I am. Oh, yes, I am.
Did you give her a lot of hard times? I'm done.
It's a learning experience, just like everything else in life. Mm-hmm. There's no manual for it. Mm-hmm. You learn as you go. The only thing that you have to be is committed. Committed and know that every problem you face, you can't concentrate on the personalities. You must concentrate on the problem.
How important is your ministry? How important is your ministry? I mean, wait a minute. Let me rephrase that question. Do you think at some point in time did you sacrifice parts of your ministry to keep your marriage stronger? And the reason I'm asking is because my mom and dad, and back in the day when she was a missionary, she was traveling a lot, and my dad wasn't a safe person, he was opposed to her traveling so much. So it created conflicts and it created problems. Mm-hmm. Where you would say the husband does have a right to mm-hmm. want his wife present and accountable for, mm-hmm. you know, wifely duties and the raising of the kids and so forth, but she's out on God's mission. Where's the balance there? What do you say? Okay, I know I have to speak here, but my family comes first. Mm-hmm. What has this ever been an issue, and how did you handle it?
Never an issue for us, mm-hmm. because before I could take on any assignment,
yes,
the Lord brings it to me. Mm-hmm. Before I gives it to Him. So when Ooh. I go to Him and I ask, "Honey, I'm going to go to Africa," He said, "Okay." I said, "That's it." He said, "That's okay. The Lord told me you're going to go to Africa."
Wow.
So that's when that unity we're talking about right now.
So you didn't worry about the finances or with the household?
No. And every time I take a trip, mm-hmm. it's always out of God's pocket. He always made the way.
So, you know, I just realized myself what happened with that question. I just realized what the difference was. I did explain this is before my dad became saved. Mm-hmm. And then there was a problem and there's an issue. I think I'm about to answer my own question.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The difference if you are both saved.
Got to be equally yoked.
Equally, there it is.
Because
equally.
It would have been a problem.
But I'm saying, if you were to give advice to it's happening right now. There mm-hmm. are saved and unsaved marriages.
Mm-hmm.
What would be your advice to that saved person, be it the husband or the wife, how to keep their marriage and their Christianity and their ministry strong?
What you have to remember, your first ministry is to God. You can you can do that anywhere. You can do that in your bedroom, in your car, mm-hmm. wherever you are. Your next ministry is to your family.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can offer a ministry outside your family after that. But it's always God, family, ministry.
You know, I actually had a situation with my wife where I say, "Honey, I got to back off you a little bit. I don't want God to smite you. to smite you because I'm paying too much attention to you." I say, "Come on." I say, "I'll have to back up off you a little. Just mm-hmm. a little bit." Because, you know, y'all know me. I love my wife. Oh, I love her dearly. That's my queen. And I love God. So there's, I mean, honey, I know you out there watching, but, I mean, God, family.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
It's the natural order of things.
Everything falls afterwards.
Her being a Christian too, she understands.
Amen.
So, like, I still want you to talk to those that couple out there who was dealing with a situation where they're saved and the husband is unsaved, or they're saved and believe it or not, and the wife is mm-hmm. not saved. Mm-hmm. How do you talk to them? Look in that camera right there and talk.
My advice to you is this: if you have an unsaved spouse
mm-hmm.
and you are saved, especially a woman, because most women always be the ones who are saved and their husbands are not.
I mean, the church is full of women. Where are the men?
Exactly. A woman, when you are saved mm-hmm. and your husband is not saved, he is saved through you because you sanctify him through you.
Wow.
That's how you work it out. And you got to be the role model to show that husband that this is where I'm at. He'll do things mm-hmm. that you would not like. But you have to be the one to stand and show the God in you so he can come over.
Mm.
But if you show yourself different, and say you are saved, you will not win his soul for the Lord because he's watching you. Every move that you make, he's watching you. That's why I want my husband to the Lord, is he watched me. And by watching me, 6 months later, he was into the kingdom Ooh. With me. And this is from 1986, we were saved and serving God. So I just want you to be encouraged. Don't take it in your heart that this man ain't gone. He's just being bad. No, you were out one time too.
Sorry.
Yeah, you out one time too. Until you became a child of God. Now you see all his faults. But you was making the same faults mm-hmm. he was making too. Vice versa. So don't you ever put yourself on a pedestal that you're better than your husband, you're better than your wife, because you're not. Because mm-hmm. God sees you for who you really are.
As far as, would you advise marriage to an unsaved couple? Would you advise that?
If they're equally yoked, yes. Mm. If they're unequally yoked, then two sinners, get married, because you're marrying equally yoked.
Oh, wow.
But if you're a Christian person seeking a man or a woman who is not saved, walk away.
Wow.
Because you're not equally yoked, and you're going to have a whole lot of issues. Mm-hmm. And you can't say, get married to a man to get the man saved. Get him saved first, then marry him. Or vice versa.
Well, that certainly sounds like a plan.
The unique thing about that is that the Bible says, you know, two can only walk down a road if they're going down that road together.
The same road.
And so when you take that on to yourself, somebody who is unequally yoked with somebody who is yoked, you're already looking for problems because you're going in two different directions. And so there would be friction, and somebody has to give in so that you can walk in one direction.
Well, I know there's lots more that this couple can share with us, right? But you guys are going to just have to go to the summit. If you live in the Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach area, this is the place to be. Where is it?
It's going
to
be at 3840 Inver Mary Country Club, Lauderhill, Florida, 33319.
And when?
At March 11th.
March 11th, folks.
At 12 at 7 p.m.
Wow.
And that's 3840 Inver Mary Country Club, Lauderhill, Florida, 33319. I'm looking forward to seeing you there. Bring all your loved ones.
And the conference is free.
Wow. Hey, he said the magic words. Anyway, we'll be right back with more of Musgrove Music Gospel Corner.
Are you tired of failed attempts at dieting? Don't you wish you had more energy? Are aches and pains slowing you down? Now is the time to give Nucentia a try.
Nucentia products are made from natural ingredients formulated to heal the body from inside out. Our products are held to the highest standards of quality and provide 100% daily vitamins and nutrients for all. Go ahead now to turn back that aging clock. Try Nucentials today.
Brenda Solomon, Nucentia representative and success story.
I'm Anthony Mayo, a lawyer at Traffic Ticket Office. For the past 20 years, our firm has successfully handled over 1 million traffic violations for our clients in Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach County. Our firm handles all non-criminal violations, starting at just $69, and we guarantee no points or your money back.
We also handle all types of criminal violations. Our goal is to get your case dismissed. Call us today at 305-751-6881 or visit us on the web at trafficticketoffice.com.
Come on to the Traffic Ticket Office.
Hi, and welcome back to Musgrove Music Gospel Corner. Hey, I guess you're wondering who's this lovely lady sitting next to me. I think I'm going to hold you an expense for exactly. Who are you?
I am.
How do I have the privilege of being seated next to you right now?
I am Pastor Tasha Gilmore, and it is a pleasure to be here today.
Say that again.
I am Pastor Tasha Gilmore, and it's a pleasure to be here this evening.
I thought she was like one of those runway models or something like that. But on a serious note, I know I'm here for a really good reason. And this is to tell people about what you're doing. Mm-hmm. And because if you watch the history of our show, we only bring on people who are doing positive things for this community. Be it in ministry. This is a ministry-based a network TV show. But we also try to highlight people who are doing positive stuff in the community. But it seems like you're doing both. You're a double hitter. What else you got under your belt you're not telling me about?
Well, I think you've had a chance to hear a lot about what I've been doing. Mainly, I'm launching.
But they want to hear it.
Absolutely. I'm launching the School of the Prophetess in West Palm Beach, and it is an amazing opportunity to train and equip women who have a calling in the prophetic. Mm-hmm. Now, we can talk a lot about the role of the prophetess. We are hearing that title more and more today.
Every day,
we?
I mean.
Every day.
It just kind of sprang up.
Mm-hmm. Well, the beauty of the School of the Prophetess is we have an opportunity to take it back.
Wait a minute, did you say school?
School of the Prophetess. Yes.
Okay, what's the role? What do you do there?
My role with the school is I am the organizer. I have the wonderful pleasure of bringing the school to West Palm Beach, launching it, organizing it, being the registrar, and getting it kicked off.
Now, you say West Palm Beach, we're international ministry, so tell people exactly where it is. I mean, you said Palm Beach. Some people may think it's Palm Beach, New York. Where's that? Palm Beach is in California.
West Palm Beach, Florida.
There we go. That's what I'm trying to get out of you. So what's the name of the school?
The name of the school is the School of the Prophetess. Mm-hmm. It is an independent school that trains and equips women to bring them into their feminine prophetic anointing. So mm-hmm. we train them, we equip them, and we release them. We release them back to their local churches.
Well, have you noticed that everyone so far who signed up just wasn't equipped? And what do you do with someone, and when it's obvious, it may not be obvious to them, mm-hmm. but they just not cut out for it, they're just not called for it. Mm-hmm. I mean, how do you break it through them? Or have you had that situation?
We haven't had that situation mm-hmm. because the beauty of the program is, it's not just training them to be a prophet. It's training them to minister. It's training them and equipping them in the role within the local church. Now, maybe they may come in as an evangelist and believe they have a calling to the prophetic. Mm-hmm. We help them to develop that gift. And if indeed that is truly not their ultimate calling, mm-hmm. they will still leave the program with skills and ministry training mm-hmm. that they can apply to any role in the local church.
Valley to victory. Valley to victory.
Yes.
How did that come about?
Valley to Victory is actually my ministry.
Okay.
It came about from personal experience. I went through mm-hmm. a painful period in my life. I went through a period where after 15 years, I was going through a divorce. And wow. then after the divorce, I lost my job.
Wow.
And then I became very, very ill. And it was that time where the doctor looked at me and said, "Well, we finally know what you have, but there's no cure." So I was in the valley.
So is that your inspiration behind the name of the
that
ministry?
That is the inspiration behind, because what I realized is from that valley experience that God himself was going to take me to the victory. And he did. He wow. brought me out of that valley.
Wow.
And restored my life in an amazing way.
Now, I don't want to pry, but can you share a little more about that experience? Mm-hmm. And I mean, How deep did you sink? Did you sink into like a depression, or were you prayed up enough to say, you know, God, I know you're going to take me out of this?
I sank to a low point mm-hmm. where I tried to kill myself two times.
Wow.
On my second suicide attempt.
Wow.
I literally came out of my body and was over my body.
Wow.
And I could look down and see myself on the ground. And the way I had fallen, I said to myself, that has to hurt. And then when I realized that I could see myself, I knew I was no longer in my body.
It was that bad?
It was that bad. I came out of that second suicide attempt, and as I hovered over my own body, I said, God, if you give me another chance, I will get it right. Mm-hmm. And that's how far in the valley I was.
You know what? While reading over your bio, I came across Giant Slayer. Giant Slayer.
Yes.
I mean, we all know the story of David.
Yes, we do.
How does your story differ?
The story is completely different. Giant Slayer is a message that I come out and I do in a mm-hmm. one-day seminar or a half-day workshop. Giant Slayer. So many times we hear about facing our giants. I've heard that message many times
yeah.
from many different pastors, that you need to just face mm-hmm. your giants. Well, let me tell you something. In this season, you're going to have to do more than face your giants. You need to slay them.
Mm-hmm.
So that message is all about how to rise up and slay them. The Israeli army came out for 40 days and faced Goliath. Came out and faced Goliath for 40 days. So facing that giant is not enough. There had to be someone like David who rose up to slay the giant. So that message is all about how you too can rise up and slay the giants in your
wow.
life.
I mean, I'm going to ask you a question. It's kind of similar to a question I asked to numerous guests. I mean, friends, I mean, how long ago did this incident happen to you? You say the 15-year marriage. How long ago are we talking about? What time frame? Was this recent or a few years back?
It was several years back.
Several years back.
Yes, I'm actually in my second marriage, and I'm going on 10 years in my second marriage. So
oh, okay.
God completely gave me a new life.
So here's my question.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing what you know now, right? If you were to be able to go back in time and speak to that person, you, 15 mm-hmm. years ago, what would you say?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, at your lowest point. I'm talking about you, the one that was trying to kill yourself.
Mm-hmm.
What would you say?
Mm-hmm.
And keep in mind, someone might hear mm-hmm. this.
Absolutely.
That's contemplating something similar.
Mm-hmm.
So, take it away. Absolutely. Talk to that person 15 years, so, like you're talking to yourself. Mm-hmm. Make it personal.
Mm-hmm. No matter what you're going mm-hmm. through, there's a God who loves you. And there's a God who has a plan for you. Mm-hmm. He says in his word that he knows the plans he has for you. And maybe right now mm-hmm. you don't see it. Maybe right now you don't understand it. Maybe you're going through so much pain that you just feel that there's no other way out. Because that's where I was. I felt there was no other way out. I just don't want to be here anymore. But I am so grateful today that God preserved me and he saved my life, that he sent me back. Mm-hmm. Because looking now, I can now see how God had a perfect plan and he was putting all the pieces to work. And that's what I want to say to you. God is putting the pieces together. Don't give up. Don't lose heart. Get connected with people who can strengthen and encourage you. One of the things I do, I'm a Christian life coach, and I work with a lot of women. I work with them one-on-one mm-hmm. to coach them and help them to really put their life together and to see the direction that God has, so I'm able to work and pull that out of them. Because mm-hmm. sometimes we just don't see, you know, that God has a plan, and we don't see how the pieces of who we are today really fit together for our future. So you have to know and just press into God. Know he has more for you.
I have another question, and because I actually had this conversation with my wife recently, and I said, you know what, I'm seeing a lot more and more female ministers mm-hmm. in every aspect of ministry. Mm-hmm. And then before I even finished my statement to my wife, I said, wait a minute. If the men were doing their jobs, mm-hmm. if you go to church, it's 90% women, 90% mm-hmm. women.
Right.
And I do believe, for those of you just gentlemen who don't believe that women should be in ministry, why aren't you doing your job? But anyway, I'm not bashing men. I'm not, that's not what I'm trying to do. Mm-hmm. Answer me this, riddle me this. What exactly is a prophetess?
Mm-hmm. A prophet is a man or woman who is used by God to relay a message either to an individual or a group of people.
Okay. Would it be safe to say that these specific people, men or female, has to have a calling from God?
Absolutely.
Before they can walk in the prophetic?
Absolutely. Ephesians 4 is very clear about mm-hmm. that. There are set officers that have been established. Pastor, prophetess, those are positions that have been established mm-hmm. by God for the kingdom. So yes, they should be called. There are a lot of people today who are using the title of prophetess. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
The beauty of the school of the prophetess is we look at taking the meaning back to a biblical meaning. What does the word of God say about the role of a prophet? Mm-hmm. What examples do we have in the word of God about prophets?
Because, I mean, I'm trying to be impartial here.
Yes.
You see?
Yes.
Because when we had the conversation and you told me what you were up, I was intrigued because I really want to know.
Mm-hmm.
How do you teach someone? Mm-hmm. How do you teach someone the skill set, I mean, even the mind frame that they must be in, even the prayer regimen or the, how do you teach them mm-hmm. to be a proper prophetess or prophet?
Mm-hmm. A lot of it is through mentoring. To be quite honest, they have to have a calling to the office. I mean, mm-hmm. we do not
that's
deny
first,
that.
That's there first and foremost.
Be,
they have
there
to have.
Has to have oh. There has to be a calling to the office.
Mm-hmm.
People could come and say they feel they are called. We will work with them one-on-one. We mentor them. We take them through training. And we help them to define that gift. We help them to refine the gift. And then there's a part where there's an impartation towards the end of the program. Where truly, if they have gone through the program and they are called, and it's something where it's a team that prays over them, it's mm-hmm. a team that walks with them. We're not just saying, you're a prophetess, go on out there. This is not a male program. This is not an online program.
Uh-huh.
This is a mentoring program. The conference is mm-hmm. 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
Come, learn for the 3 days of the conference, but then join the school of the prophetess and continue in training.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you won me over when you said you acknowledged that they had to be called.
Yes, absolutely.
I mean, that was big for me. That was very, very important for me. Because I know personally some people who are pastors that I really don't think they should be pastors.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not for me to say.
Mm-hmm.
Because in my experience, I know for a fact God is the only person that will fire you.
Mm.
You'll never see heaven, but you still got to do his work.
Yes.
He's the only person.
Absolutely.
He'll make that, pardon my French, he'll make the ass talk to get his word
mm-hmm.
across.
Mm-hmm.
The burning bush, God, you can't sum him up in a few words. You see, you just really just can't. And I applaud you for what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if this will help people get clear direction on what they are truly doing and help them to define what they are truly called for.
Yes.
I think what you're doing is a good thing.
And calling is really important. My father is a bishop and he's mm-hmm. overseer of the Body of Christ International as well as a leadership institute. And there have been people that have said they were called. And I have literally seen my father had to just let them know.
Say, pump your brakes.
That's right. Let them know. We need to sit in prayer. You know, we need to talk about where you are and where God is really taking you. And sometimes mm-hmm. that's a tough message when you have to let someone know that maybe they have not been called to ministry. Maybe they didn't hear God right. Maybe they don't have the skills yet. And it's not to say that they cannot develop in many areas, but there are some offices within ministry that you need to be called to.
I don't want to take away this from the seriousness of what this conversation is all about. But I was privy to a conversation where a lady married a pastor just because she wanted to be called first lady.
I know someone like that. Yes, I know someone like that. Yes, I do. It happens.
I mean, don't it hurt you to your core when you see people dilute the word of God?
Mm.
Just dilute it to fit their own purposes.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe if we have, things in place like this, if past true pastors, not just the prophetess, the school of the prophetess, people that can really train pastors and not just learn to spit the Bible, blah, 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 this verse and that verse, because I know devils who can do that.
Mm-hmm. The demons know the word.
I mean, even police officers have to have sensitivity training. Mm-hmm. Why don't pastors?
I think pastors need to go through a lot of training, but one mm-hmm. of the things that you said that really hit me right now is that the prophetess,
mm-hmm.
just the title itself
mm-hmm.
has been so overused.
Yeah.
It has been so overused. And one of the things that really got me involved in the School of the Prophetess, I mean, I have my own ministry. Mm-hmm. Right now I'm building a ministry training center over mm-hmm. in Dominican Republic. So, so I have my own ministry and my own work.
Cristo te ama. Got to brush up on my Spanish. I want to come over there and interview you.
Well, this is through my organization.
Ooh, I'm shameless, ain't I?
Yes.
Well, this is a section of our program where we say a shameless plug, but there's nothing shameless about what you're doing. So this is the part where you tell people everything you want them to know about your upcoming events and what you got going on in the community and invite them out. So that's yours for the next 1 minute. Take it away.
Come out to the School of the Prophetess, which will be in West Palm Beach, Florida, mm-hmm. March 4th, 5th, and 6th at 1903 Donnelly Road in West Palm Beach, 33407. And you can contact us at schooloftheprophetess.com. You can also call 561-444-8125.
Here's the good thing about TV. You don't have to repeat that. It'll be on the bottom of the screen. We're going to take a quick break because these pesky commercial people, they want their monies. They want their... Anyway, let me stop there, my supporters. Anyway,
yes,
we'll
are.
Be right back after these words from our lovely, nice-looking, respectful, beautiful sponsors.
Are you tired of failed attempts at dieting? Don't you wish you had more energy? Are aches and pains slowing you down? Now is the time to give New Central a try.
Your essential products are made from natural ingredients formulated to heal the body from inside out. Our products are held to the highest standards of quality and provide 100% daily vitamins and nutrients for all. Go ahead now to turn back that aging clock. Try Nucentrals today.
Brenda Solomon, Nucentral representative and success story.
Welcome back to more of Musgrove Music Gospel Corner. I'm a little bit humble right now. Well, I'm a lot humble right now. Is that a word? A lot humble? Anyway, y'all philosophers out there, y'all sift that through. But look, I'm surrounded by two powerful women of God. And while Miss Johnson here was sitting in the green room, they realized that they have one person in common that's at the forefront of this school for the apostles.
Prophets.
For the prophecies, I'm sorry. Maybe there should be one though. Honey, take a note of that. I said it first. So, can you share your experiences dealing with this wonderful man of God? We haven't mentioned him much, but I would like for someone to open that door and mention him. Don't all speak at once.
Well, I had the wonderful opportunity to meet with Apostle Ernest Cobbs, and he is the person who launched the School of the Prophetess. He originally launched the school in London, UK, and he is now bringing it to West Palm Beach. So just, I captured his vision, just listening to him about how he wanted to equip women to be prophetess, to walk in their feminine prophetic anointing. And something about when I had the opportunity to sit down with him and really hear his heart for training women, preparing them, and then releasing them into their call of God in their local church. And that was the beauty about what he was doing. He wasn't starting his own church. He wasn't trying to just bring people into his church. It was about equipping women to go back and serve in the houses that they were already planted in. And I love that.
What's been your experience with it?
You know, I met Apostle Cobbs at one of my events. And he sat right through the very front. And like, both of our spirits just connect. And when it was all over, I walked over by him. And I said, I have to shake your hands. And I reached and I hold his hand. And like, that warmth, that connection, we've got that connection. And he said to me, we're going to do a lot together. I said, yeah, I believe so.
Wow.
And then when he called me up about, I called him about 2 months ago. So I'm having a marriage summit. I want you to be one of my speakers. He said, I'll be more than happy. We are now in covenant.
Wow.
We became covenant partners.
Ain't God good, people?
Oh, yes.
He has a way of connecting his people for the greater good. So I hear that you're an author.
That's right.
Wow.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about your book. What's
Absolutely.
The name of it?
The name of the book is 101 Affirmations for Living Victoriously. And that really came from that season in my life where I went through the valley. What brought me through the valley was the Word of God. And I just started to write scriptures down just for myself to just meditate on, to really feed on, and to encourage myself and strengthen myself. And when I looked at the end of it, I had over 100 scriptures. And I realized, you know what? This has helped me to get through this valley, to get through this season.
Oh, wow.
And I believe that this particular set of scriptures would help someone else. And it's scriptures like, I am victorious. I can do all things through Christ. I am the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. I shall eat of the goodness of the land. I am blessed.
Wow.
I am highly favored. I am empowered to prosper. So it was just a continual feasting on the Word of God that helped me to overcome the situations that I was going through. And I'm so grateful for the Word. Grateful for the Word of God.
A school for prophetess. I mean, have you noticed that there are increasingly more and more prophetess, I mean, being called to the ministry? Why do you think that is?
I believe there are more and more people who are taking the title of prophet or prophetess. And we definitely do see that more today than any other time. That is why I'm embracing the School of the Prophetess, to lay a sound foundation on biblical teaching about the office of the prophet as well as the prophetess. I mean, we need to have an understanding and we need to take it back to the Word.
So what's your take on it?
Well,
why, I mean, all of a sudden, it seems like it's all of a sudden, you know, mm-hmm. for better choice or worse, all of a sudden, you look around there, prophets, apostles.
But it's not all of a sudden, you know. Go back in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Who was the first messenger in the Word of God?
Okay.
It was Mary, wasn't she?
Mm-hmm.
She took the first message out. Mm-hmm. She was the first prophet in the Bible. Go back and read.
Wow.
When was the first messenger?
Wow.
And that's where we came as prophetess. When God speak to His women, we don't think, we just speak.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
We don't try to compromise God. Mm-hmm. We just say what God asks us to say. That's what we do.
I can't describe this feeling I'm having right now. I mean, I just can't describe it. And what are your takes?
I believe that every Christian, every believer,
mm-hmm.
is imparted with the Holy Spirit when they accept Christ. The Holy Spirit comes into them. So I believe every believer has a level of revelation knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're imparted with that. Now, there's a specific gifting for the prophetic. But I believe that the school of the prophetess is open to every believer
mm.
who wants to grow deeper in the Word, who wants to start to hear God better, who wants to be able to discern the voice of the Holy Spirit within. Because that's what the training is really about. And there are truly those who are prophetic. God will impart a specific word to them for a group of people or for individuals, and they need to learn how to deliver that word. How do you
mm-hmm.
deliver that word in due season? How do you deliver it exactly as you are hearing and not pull it through the funnel
mm-hmm.
of your own experiences? That's the beauty of the school of the prophetess, is training people to now deliver
mm-hmm.
that word.
I know we kind of skipped over really quickly about you being an author, but tell us where we can pick that up, that book up. It seems very interesting. 101
Affirmations
wow.
for Living Victoriously. And that can be purchased right through my website,
mm-hmm.
which is valleytovictory.com. And you can
Y'all
also get the message, Become a Giant Slayer, mm-hmm. through the website, valleytovictory.com.
Well, what does that mean to you, to become a giant slayer?
To become a giant slayer is conquering those things in your life that
mm-hmm.
have been your giants. See, people have lots of giants. For me, I had a giant of depression. I had
wow.
a giant of despair. I had many giants. Some people have the giant of addiction.
Mm-hmm.
Some people have the giant of just a fear. Of fear, anxiety, worry. There are many giants
mm-hmm.
that come into our lives. But through the power of God, we can slay every single one.
Can you identify with these giants? And have you had a few of them?
You don't want to put my story out here.
Hey.
Everything she is saying, I could vouch. I had the inner body experience.
Mm-hmm.
I tried to commit suicide several times.
Wow.
Because I was raped by the age 16.
Wow.
And I want to take my life.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't happen.
Mm-hmm.
God kept me for this time. And you're talking about prophet, back to the prophets. That's a gift that comes within.
Mm-hmm.
We all are God mouthpiece.
Mm-hmm.
We all are prophets. But what we call to speak from the word above, which is God above,
mm-hmm.
it's a difference. We can all speak as a prophet,
mm-hmm.
but is it effective enough? Is it really
mm-hmm.
coming from God? Prophets stay on their face constantly,
mm-hmm.
hearing from the word of
mm-hmm.
God. That's what a prophet is. I won't call myself a prophet, but I know God have been using me mightily in that word, prophet. I call myself
mm-hmm.
a pastor.
Mm-hmm.
I know God have been using me mightily as a prophet.
Well, I'm going to put you on the spot right now. You heard what she just said.
Mm-hmm.
What would be your advice to her? Because of, you heard what she just said. She doesn't call herself a prophet, but she's walking in the prophetic word.
I am not a prophet. I am not a prophetess. My calling is to be a pastor.
Mm.
So I think you have to be sure of what your calling is. And I'm attending the School of Prophetess because I believe that in each of us
mm-hmm.
is the ability to hear from God and to grow into the prophetic.
I think that's what she
that's
just
what I'm
what,
saying.
Exactly what she
that's
just
yes
said.
That's just what I'm saying.
Yes.
Because I believe I'm saying this. I have proven God, using this article here, this
mm-hmm.
article, to bring
mm.
forth His word. And not just in Africa, China, Haiti, but I traveled to bring forth this word
mm.
of God, just right here. Within my own life, I was diagnosed with cancer.
Mm-hmm.
I was supposed to be dead a long time.
Mm-hmm.
I was in Africa, I was dead with malaria.
Mm.
I'm here, I'm sitting here. I had a daughter who was dead. She's back because of prayer.
Mm.
I prophesied to women having babies. They had the babies. Mm. I see things happen. And I speak it, and it just happens. That's what I watch. Wow. Just come out of this mouth. But they got me as a pastor. Mm-hmm. But I don't work on none. I'm God's mouthpiece.
Yeah.
And that's the way I did my ministry.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I don't like names.
Amen.
I don't like the name. Just let me do what God want me to do.
Wow.
I agree with you there. Mm-hmm. Because there are a lot of people who are holding on to titles. I think the bottom line is, we're here to serve the Lord.
That's it.
It's not about the title. It's not about sitting on the front row. I'm an elder. I'm a pastor. But I sit in the second row. I don't care about the front row. It's not about the front row. It's about serving the Lord and doing the work He's called us to do.
Like I said, I power the front row. It's not like the front row. Because in the back row, too much distraction.
I don't sit in the back either.
So in the front, yes. There's no distraction. I love the front seat.
I mean, right now, I would put my 2 cents in, but right now, I only feel like it's actually worth 2 cents because I'm sitting next to these two powerful women of God. And, I mean, people are going so far these days. I've been to churches where they had first ladies parking space. So people do really tend to hold on to these titles and just grab them, which I think what's alarming is for a lot of them do it for a lot of the wrong reasons. So that's why I think this school is important. So tell us a little more about the school.
Sure. Well, we are looking forward to launching the school. The school is launching with a 3-day mm-hmm. conference. From the 3 days, it's going to go on and then go over 8 weeks. So we're looking for people to come out to the 3-day conference. You will get an initial training in the School of the Prophetess. Mm-hmm. You will get some training that you can walk away with and apply and use and refine the gift of your anointing. But then we're really looking for people to come back. Come back for the school, spend the next 8 weeks with us, go through the classes, and the school is going to go even beyond there. But that's our initial session. Mm-hmm. It's going to be the 3-day conference and then 8 weeks of classes.
Anything you want to add to this, what we're talking to this topic?
Folks probably saying, what is the price?
Yes.
That's on their minds. What are the costs?
Oh, well, let me tell you, the conference is amazingly reasonable. Uh-huh. It is only $20 in advance. $25 at the door. That is for all 3 nights of the conference.
That's lunch money.
$20 in advance, $25 at the door, and it's all 3 days.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And then I can add this in there. For all you ladies, you have been called to be a prophet, or you're thinking in your heart that you are a prophet, come out. I encourage you to come out. Do you know exactly what your calling really is? Mm-hmm. If it's not prophet, leave it alone. Do what God called you to do. We always send you for a purpose. So come on out and find exactly what is your calling in God. You might find might not be a prophet or a prophetess, but you could be. But you have to not apply yourself with this word of God called prophetess. Mm-hmm. And you must spend time in that word to hear from God, that intimate time. You got that secret place.
Mm.
You can't be a prophet up in everybody's business. I'm keeping it real.
Yes.
Am I right or wrong, Pastor?
You're right.
That's what a prophet is all. You're locked away.
It's a lonely world.
When God called you, it's very lonely. There's nobody, just you, God, in the closets.
Yes.
Or the bathrooms and the books.
Wow.
That's what prophet is all about.
Wow. I hope you've out there learned a lot today, as I have. I'm very humbled right now. Now, I ain't gonna let y'all see me cry, so. We here at Musgrove Music wanna thank you for joining us for this powerful episode of Musgrove Music Gospel Corner. I mean, I've had an enlightening experience right now today. I mean, I'm very seldom at a loss for words. But I wish I could transfer to you guys what I'm feeling right now. But let me just put it this way. God is real. Experience Him for yourself. And anything you do, do it in Jesus' name. See you next week on Musgrove Music Gospel Corner.
Hi, I'm Cardinal Musgrove, Vice President of Musgrove Music. And here's what we've been up to for the past year. Come, follow me.
Musgrove.
Yeah, come on, come on. Put your hands up.
Musgrove Music is about spreading the word of God throughout the atmosphere. Every airwave that's possible, through radio, through TV, you name it, we're about spreading the word of God. Well, we see Musgrove Music taking this thing globally. When I say globally, I mean all far corners of this earth. We're talking South Africa, Ethiopia, North America, South America. We're talking, you name it, we're talking Musgrove Music going global, spreading the word of God. Yes, we've worked with artists such as Second Chance.
If you're here tonight and you believe that there's nobody greater than Jesus, make some noise to Jesus. This one is produced by brother Daniel Musgrove. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. D. Back.
Liz Thomason. J-Baz. While on my knees, asking Jesus, please teach me how to live so that the world may see, yeah, that you live in me, and Lord, that you've given me a chance for eternal life. If I just live it right,
I'm going to see my Lord someday. Thank you, Lord, for showing me the way.
You know, some of the reggae greats, Clifton Clark.
Something happened to me, I want to tell it straight to you. I was walking along the railroad track.
You know, upcoming artists such as Devonette Buckner.
King of kings, Lord of all, he sits on the throne and rules.
Artists such as Stefan Peninsula, Mr. Breastleg and Tie.
Sada, 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 Stefan Peninsula, alongside Mr. Daniel Musgrove. Let me tell you, we are taking place to our next level. I am with Trumpet Devil. Where, Mr.? Where you say nobody can stop you, Mr. Daniel? Where you there? Talk, my boy.
Artists such as Christine Morrison, newcomer to the music scene. Des Rose, of course, can't forget Des Rose. Gospel community. Now we're branching off into the contemporary gospel scene.
You know, we've done stuff with people such as Johnny Sanders so far.
I worship you in the beauty of holiness. I worship you, oh Lord.
In good times and in bad, you're the only true friend I've ever had. The things you brought me through, even when I doubted you, Lord, you still came through. Yes, you did. Lord, you still came through. I worship you.
We've been working real hard on this new album, On Bended Knees, so it's time to take it to the road.
Praise the Lord! I'm not ashamed. Anywhere. I was in the gas station about to pump gas. My wife, the beautiful lady right there, she dared me, say, praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord! A lady at the pump next to me, she said, I don't know what you're praising God for, but hallelujah! Yay! Now, don't you think that boosts me up?
Yes, sir.
It boosts me up to the point where I can go anywhere, be in front of anybody, and say hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Say praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And if they look at me crazy, it's just a matter of time before they be saying it to me.
Amen.
So, I will try to sing this little song from my new album called On Bended Knees. Just bear with me right now.
But it's not impossible. I'm taking back everything that the devil stole. I'm in the fight for my life, trying to save my soul. And I'm armed to the teeth with the word of God. Here I come and I ain't taking no prisoner. Devil gotta flee with the words God's giving me. He's cruising for a bruising and he gonna get it, cause I'm covered by the blood and his righteousness.
I'm on the offensive, taking the fight to the enemy.
Attack. We're gonna lay the devil out flat on his back. Don't let him up, don't give him a breather. Round one, we're gonna hit him with an uppercut. Round two, gonna hit him with the body blows. Round three, gonna hit him with a right cross. Round four, ain't gonna be no round four. Let's hit him with everything we got.
I'm on the offensive,
weapon of choice, with the breastplate of righteousness. I can withstand any attack of the enemy. So I'm calling all my soldiers in Christ to join the fight. It's time to make a stand. No surrender, no retreat. On the offensive until the final victory is won. In the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Taking the fight to the end.
life trying to save my soul. And I'm